Quick shout out to Armadillo Tech for sending us this rugged case so we can review it on this channel. We did review the same case for the Galaxy Note 9 last year, and I gotta tell you, it was a very, very good case. So definitely super excited to check in this one out. So in the box, we got, let's see, it's just a personalized letter. Pretty nice. Put this on the side for now. And on the back, we got some more paperwork. Okay. And just the same letter, it seems. So you do get instructions on how to set it up. I'm going to show you how to install it, but also on their side, you can go in there and that will also show you how to do the installation, but let's get right into it. So now this case is going to be a two-piece case, and the way it works basically. So first you find your ports in the bottom and you identify it correctly. And then we're going to go ahead and get the buttons on the right to line up, get the button on the left, and then we're going to pop it on the bottom. Once we make sure everything is lined up correctly, then we're gonna wrap it around the other case in the back. And usually I start from the bottom. I make sure I slide in the ports that usually are sticking out, just makes it easier. And then we just go around the case, just sliding it right in there. And once you get it up to the corners, it goes right in there. Then you just kind of go around, make sure everything's stuck right in there. Everything is good. Pretty easy installation. As you notice it, it's not that hard at all. Take your time when you get it. If you do decide to get it, it's gonna offer you two different tones, which really like the blue on this one. And now it does come in different colors. We'll check it out in a second. Definitely liking the design, how they did it in the back. You got a kind of like futuristic design. And on the sides, you do have pretty good grip. The plastic is not, it's not like that cheap plastic. It doesn't feel cheap at all. Definitely feels good on the hand. It feels premium. It's not gonna be your cheap case that it's gonna come apart after a month, after 2 months. And it's not that soft plastic at all either, where it's gonna start peeling off or kind of coming loose on the edges, based on what I experienced with the Galaxy Note 9 case, the same one that I got last time. Now with this Vanguard series case, it's gonna offer you some of the maximum protection that you're gonna get out of the other box. Now, this is gonna cost you around $23. The other box can run you between $40, $60, $70, depending on the case that you're looking for, but this is gonna offer you some of the maximum protection. Buttons are pretty clickable, no issues with the buttons here. Check them out, Bixby. And you got your body rockers, pretty clickable. Not super soft, but they're not hard at all. I mean, they're clickable. It works fine. When it comes to the ports right in the bottom, your speaker, your microphone, there's no issues there. Now you do have your dust protector. So if you are using this out in the environment, it kind of asks you more protection for the charging port and your audio jack. Another thing that I check out on this case is that I'm able to open this and close it pretty easily. And this one is very user friendly. So you can see it does come off and goes back in there with no issues. And on the top, again, you have your cutout for the other speaker. Right on the side, you do have the Armadillo name brand, and then you have this arrow kind of design going down, which adds more grip to the case. So this case is going nowhere. If you got a good hold of it, it's not gonna go anywhere. Cut out on the top on the front for the speaker, something I've been checking out. It's right on point. It will not block your speaker right on the front. Another thing that I want to point out, so thing that I really like about this case is the kickstand that you get in the back. So if you do use this in the office, you're going to be able to consume content. Either you can use it parallel or you can just horizontal, and it works great. Like pretty good feature. And if you don't need it, it goes right in there and it doesn't even feel like it's there. So I really like this feature for this type of case. Now, I did mention that they do come in different colors. Let's check them out real quick. So it does come on a kind of like a vibrant orange and gray, which is very nice. You got all black charcoal, the blue gray that we took a look at today, and then you got a purple one. And the prices are going to vary between $21 and $23. So definitely, if you guys want to check this one out, I'll have links in the description below. And if you just want before, hey, let us know in the comment section below. Another thing is you're not going to have a screen protector on this one. And I know because a lot of companies have been having issues with the ultrasonic fingerprint reader. So on this one, on the Galaxy Note 9, if you remember, we did get a plastic screen protector. But on this one, I think they were smart enough to decide not to mess with it and just leave it without a screen protector. I personally rather have it like this than having a plastic screen protector that kind of takes away from the screen. Now, when it comes to lip protection, you're going to have very good protection top and bottom, and even they're going to have an extra indentation between where the screen is and where the outer case is. So definitely if you happen to slam this case face down on the table, or if the phone just kind of slides across the room on the floor, you don't have to worry about the screen getting scratched easily. In this case, it's not going to be super thick if you want to compare it to the other box. I do have an other box here. So If you're looking for something that is similar to the OtterBox but don't want to pay $50, $60, definitely this is a great budget case you can find to replace the OtterBox. Of course, it may not be as premium when it comes to the quality, the materials that they use, but it's going to offer you a very similar protection. Let's test out the wireless charging, and it should work just fine. I tried it before. You can see it picked it up right away. Now, if you want to use a power sharing feature, for me, this has been a hit and miss. So for the buds and the watch, I can hardly ever get them to get connected. Now, if I use another phone, seems like it does pick up the connection. Definitely, this will not be 100% compatible with wireless sharing. That's just something to keep in mind. And just so you know, there's a lot of other cases that I am testing out and I noticed the same issue. Well, I wouldn't say an issue, because even when you activate power sharing, it does let you know that if you're not getting a good connection, you gotta go ahead and remove the case or anything that is blocking both of the devices. So just keep that in mind. Thank you for watching. Make sure you hit the like button if you enjoyed this content, and I'll see you on the next one.